clock on the wall. It ain't harsh now. What up, Doe? How's everyone out there today? It's fucking finally warm out here in Michigan. I went for a little walk. It was great. It was great. How you guys doing? As many of you know, I'm old as fuck. I'm not the oldest. John's older than me. But
by a couple years. Make it sound like I'm 10 years
you're
older.
You're older. You're old, though, bro. You're just something old about you.
Just old.
Yeah, man. You're like old and dusty. I guess if you dressed nicer, you wouldn't seem so old, but you just seem like you gave up. You know, like just an old dude that just gave up. You wear those busted ass pants and you run your shoes into the ground.
Just waiting to die.
Yeah, you're not even like the cool old dudes, you know?
No.
That worked at the plant and caked up and got a bunch of money. Now they got gold chains and shit like that. Some extra cars. Dress sharp. Wear Stacy Adams or some shit like that. You're just like an old dude that just gave up.
Why even bother?
Yeah, like, I could wear a clean shirt today, but this one's right next to me in bed. Fuck it.
I used to be a contender.
Yeah. But you guys know, how many times have you guys had to hear John talk about Humble County? You know what I mean? Like, you know, back in Humble County in my younger days. Back, this one time in Humble County. I was like, come on, John.
Fuck. Since then.
Yeah, when I had my own show and didn't have to work with you when I was in Humble County. Well, I'm like, I haven't thought about this. Like, I started losing my hair a long time ago. I've just come to terms with that shit that happens to every, like, I know bald 20-year-olds, you know what I mean? Like, it's just the luck of the draw. I think if you got a lot of fucking testosterone or some shit like that, it helps cause it. At least that's what we tell ourselves to feel better. But I got it. There's a new type. There's a new getting old for me. There was a new like thing that happened as you get old. Do you want to guess, John?
Let's see. Difficulty urinating. I don't know.
Pissing the bed. Nah, I had difficulty urinating from doing too much ketamine, so that doesn't count.
Let's see. Constipation. Oh, I can't go to the bathroom. This is the worst thing ever.
Sometimes that happens, but usually that's after I fucking travel. For some reason, I can't shit when I travel. Sucks.
Interesting.
Yeah, I know, right? When I went to the fucking, when I went to the funeral, I didn't use the bathroom the whole fucking time, dog. It was crazy. I'm like, come on, man. This is crazy. No, that's not it. You give up.
One final one. Right. A more aggressive case of erectile dysfunction. The pills aren't working.
Nope.
Okay. All right. I struck
it. And it's not, like, I don't keep peeing after I get done peeing either. That's what happens. Old people do that shit, too. They go to the bathroom, and they just keep leaking piss. I'm not there yet either.
Nice. You got that going for you.
I'm sure I'll be there sooner than later. But I got to get bifocals, bro. I'm going to have to get reading glasses. I can't fucking, like, what are you talking about? Like, I used to be able... Bro, I care, man. I used to like be able to look at my phone and see, and I can't now, bro. Like it's, I hit them eyeglass people. I hit up high. I'm like, y'all, I need some bifocals ASAP.
Yeah, I know. And I've actually become the guy that puts the glasses on his head when he needs to look at the phone.
Bro, that's what I yo. That's what I do. Like, it's man. I'm sitting here. I'm like, I'll be on the couch, like making my like taking. Taking the phone and putting it far away, then up close and far away, and I'm like I used to be able to fucking And it, like, it gets worse at night. I guess my eyes get tired. But, like, you know, like, you can read some shit and, like, you can squint and it'll be a little blurry, but you can guess and, like, you know, kind of figure it out as you go along. Not no more, bro. Ain't no squinting, none of that shit, man. When my eyes go, they just go. It's just straight up fucking done.
Well, you've got some money in the bank. People keep suggesting I get the LASIK surgery. So whether it's at the gym or other people, when I'm to the eye doctor, hey, you want to do LASIK?
Does LASIK, I don't even know, does LASIK help just getting old? Because this is just getting old, bro. Well, yeah, like, I don't know any vision. Fucking... Yeah, but like if you farsight and like I don't know, like does it correct needing reading glasses? Cause my eyeglasses are for astigmatisms and some other shit. I don't know what the fuck's wrong with it.
I'll have to look more
LASIK. See, but like you, how long? You're old. You're really, really old. You're so old.
It's amazing. So, I'm still breathing, right?
Yeah. When did you start losing your eyesight?
Third grade, I think I got my first pair of glasses.
No. I mean, like needing, like having to take the glasses off to try to read the shit like
kind of,
that.
That's kind of a new thing. About 2 years ago, I think.
So when you were 47?
Yeah, I was about like 55. No, like a couple of years ago. So it was like early to mid 40s, something like that.
Yeah, my shit. Yeah, it's just I'm 44, so. Whatever, man. It fucked me up. I'm like, man, I'm fucking... It's one thing going bald. You don't have to buy anything new if you go bald. Maybe a baseball hat or start doing a different haircut. But, like, this is, like, I got to straight up. I'm going to go to fucking Rite Aid and grab some fucking reading glasses, dog.
Who do I know?
I'm going to look like De Niro at the end of motherfucking Goodfellas. He's like this gangster all his life, and then suddenly got to wear them big-ass glasses and shit? Come on.
Hey, there was some guy around here. I think he was in the sports department. He always had about like 5 or 6 pairs of reading glasses at his desk. It's like, man, you are an old man.
See? Thank you. Like, now I got to go. I'm going to be that dude. I'm going to be right next to him, busting out some old ugly-ass reading glasses and shit. But, now I'm going to have to wear two. I'm going to have to rock. I'm going to walk around with a pair of glasses now.
Yeah, but don't, that, yeah, but don't
have a... my face.
Don't have, like, a collection of 8 of them at your desk. Hey, John, can you grab a pair? Like, which one? It doesn't matter. Just grab a pair. Okay, man.
I'm getting some bifocals, bro. Like, it's done. Like, I'm getting bifocals. I ain't doing no reading glasses. I'm going to lose them, bitches.
According to this very suspect website, can laser eye surgery correct the need for reading glasses? Yes, it can. Yes, it can.
All right, there you go. I might do that, but, like, that's thousands of dollars.
Correct. And insurance, the last time I checked, will not
cover
that.
They don't cover that shit.
That is
nice. I don't think my, like, LASIK's for motherfuckers that, like, are blind. I'm just not blind enough to justify that shit. Whatever.
Looks like you're a little over $5,000.
God damn.
It's kind of an investment.
Nah, dog. I'll just keep going to Rite Aid. Fuck it.
What about the contacts? I've been doing that the last couple of years.
I don't think they got contact reading glasses, dog.
Well, there's one that I was wearing for a bit that was hard to get used to, where the prescription was different in each eye. So one was for seeing nearby, one was for seeing far away. That was just kind of weird to get used to. Didn't like that. That was a little weird.
Yeah. I don't know. Anyway. Your boy's going to be fucking needing them shits or whatever, you know.
Old man Angelini.
Old man Judy. To be real with you, like, that was one, like, I kind of, like, when I was doing the readings for my new book, Finn, people are still grabbing it, though, available on Amazon. I kind of didn't like doing the reading because I couldn't see, bro. I don't even have any more dates lined up because I was having such a hard time reading.
You should get the pair that you can wear around your neck like a chain.
I might just do that, bro. You think I'm bullshitting? I might just do that, bro. Like
the grandma look.
Yeah, man, fuck it. Get put some chain, like some nice gold chains around some glasses and just rock them bitches like, fuck, whatever, man. Like, bust them out. But yeah, I didn't realize that. I didn't think about that till just now, man. I didn't like doing the readings because I couldn't read. I was having such a hard time reading.
Wow, that sounds like an after school special.
I know, right? It was when I went to Passover, and everybody reads little sections of the Passover Haggadah, and it's a booklet. I was like, oh shit, like this is gonna be tough.
Why so sad?
I got nervous.
I can't read.
I know, right? I could read. I just can't see. There was actually an old dude there, and he was like, I can't read. And we laughed at him, dog. Oh. We laughed at him. Me and my homeboy was like, hell nah. He was like, I can't read. Like, I'm going to be that dude. Lord. Ugh, fuck. All right, man, whatever.
Well, hang on. Lee out of Chicago, he suggests there's another solution.
Lee.
Hey, what's going on, fellas? How we doing?
I'm blind. How you doing, bro?
I'm good. Man, so you guys are talking. So presbyopia, okay. As you age, obviously you need readers. You know, you have trouble with your near vision. And there's a drop out there now. It's called Vuity. It's a drop that you can take once daily that'll help so you won't need your reading glasses for, 6 to 10 hours.
So wait, hold up. What do you got to take? What? Say it again.
So you're not the only person. So everyone hates wearing their reading glasses. It's a big problem. And so there's a new drop out there. It's an eye drop. You got to get a prescription for it. But yeah, it's called Vuity, and what it can do is you take that drop, and you essentially won't need your reading glasses for 6 to 10 hours.
Why is that?
What does it do? So basically what it does is it shrinks down your pupil. And so think about when you're trying to read something and you squint your eyeball. You know, when you squint, it makes it a little clearer. So what it does is it shrinks down your pupil, and so that it's extending your depth of focus. And so, it makes your near vision a lot more clear.
All right, man. Thank you. That's cool. All right. See, that's much cheaper than getting surgery and less invasive.
And all his information checks out. And he sounds like he knows what he's talking about. View it.
Yeah. He said big words when he was explaining that shit to me, and that made me believe him.
And it looks like the bottle here costs $80 of Vuity.
That ain't bad.
Yeah.
You don't got to use it all the time. You know, just bust it out when you're at Passover doing a reading for your book or some shit. Did you write a book, John?
I don't remember doing that.
I don't think so. Mm-hmm. That's what the fuck I thought, bitch. Yeah, bitch. You know I'm book writing, motherfucker. What do we got for you today? It is
Scott Burnstein.
Scott Burnstein. It's Tuesday. Is it Tuesday?
It is Tuesday. Our crime correspondent.
We got Scott. We got What Would You Do? We got the news. Do not go anywhere. It's the All Out Show. Let's go.
Hey, this shit like videos, you hear me?
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Shay 45. We got our local, I guess he's not local. We got our main crime man, Scott Burnstein here. You guys might remember Scott debunking the Irishman, among other things. Welcome to the show, Scott.
Thanks, man. You can call me local. I'm proud to be from the D.
Straight up, dog.
Hustler spirit, baby.
I thought of you the other day because I was having Chinese food at my favorite Chinese restaurant, and there was a son telling his parents about the Irishman and how good it was, and I just wanted to be like, first off, stop talking so loud. Secondly, it's all wrong. Ask my man
fake
Scott.
Fake news.
I'm saying, bro.
It was the con from the grave, baby.
Mm-hmm. Ain't that the truth? Well, shit. What are you gonna tell us about today, Scott?
We got some crazy news coming out of American gangland. You know, starting with the fact that Lorenzo Fat Cat Nichols, the Queens dope kingpin legend, just got paroled from New York State prison and has been put into the custody of the federal marshals. So the Fed out, and they can keep him for up to 4 years, but he's given the feds so much cooperation since he flipped back in the 90s that there's a good chance he could be out this summer.
So wait, hold on a second. You said he mentored Supreme?
Yeah, so before there was Supreme, there was Fat Cat. Lorenzo Nichols, Fat Cat Nichols, and Supreme and the Supreme team came up under Fat Cat.
And then who you said he flipped. How many people did he flip on?
So he flipped in the early 90s after he'd been in prison about years. He was facing murder charges. He murdered his parole officer, murdered one of his girlfriends, and then murdered a pickup kid amongst, you know, alleged others.
Yo, he murdered his parole officer?
Yeah, parole officer murdered, and he copped to that.
Wow. And his girlfriend?
And there was another police officer in Queens that was murdered that he didn't cop to, but FBI and NYPD are convinced that he ordered the murder of a uniformed police officer.
Wow.
The Queens Projects.
He cooperated, and they still ended up giving him how many years?
So they cooperated and they gave him 40 years. He served 36, I believe.
Okay.
So he's now in federal custody. And like I said, the feds can let him out anytime they want. And I don't believe the feds are going to keep him for another 4 years. They could, but I believe the feds will probably let him out this year.
Wow. That's crazy, man. What are the rumblings like?
It shouted out a lot, name checked a lot in hip hop songs and in the streets of New York. Even though he cooperated, you know, his legend and his legacy is still pretty formidable.
What you told me, I didn't hear you say he told on anybody. It sounds like he just told on himself. Or were there other people he put away?
I should know more about his cooperation. Okay. I know some of it actually dovetailed with a white boy, Rick. We can tie this into Detroit. When Fat Cat was in a protection unit with Rick in Arizona back in the 90s, they got caught moving stolen cars. So once he already cooperated, he was still doing dirt.
I mean,
but it didn't seem to affect the fact that he, you know, I believe he's 63 or 64. So he's got 25 years of life left. Not a bad deal.
Yeah, that's fucking awesome. I mean, good for him.
I mean, but think about what happened to Alpo. And I don't know if your audience knows.
Tell them.
One of the biggest New York drug kingpins of all time from Harlem. He cooperated. They made a movie about him called Paid in Full with Mekhi Phifer and Wood Harris.
It's a damn good movie. Yeah. Cameron.
Yeah. And Cameron. And Cameron's the one who played the character based on Alpo. So Alpo cut a deal, cop to murders, including Money Rich Porter, who Mekhi Phifer played in that movie, and had been out for about 5 years, was living in Maine. But was dipping back into Harlem on a regular basis, copping drugs. And right before the holidays last year in 2021, he got killed in front of a Harlem nightclub in a drug deal.
No shit. Damn.
So, I mean, these are titans. When you talk about Alpo or you talk about Nicky Barnes or Frank Lucas, I mean, that's where Fat Cat Nichols fits in, you know. So, like, Supreme Team doesn't exist without Fat Cat Nichols and his mentorship out of those Baisley Park projects in Queens. And, you know, Fat Cat Nichols' name echoed around all five boroughs. There's a famous video that I think you can find online of the Supreme Team. I think it was a New Year's Eve party, 86, and Fat Cat had just got locked up, and they had Slick Rick and a bunch of other rappers that were on stage, the hottest rappers of the year. of that era, and they were celebrating, and they stopped the music. They were playing White Lines, like the guys that wrote White Lines, Curtis Blow, and they were up on stage performing White Lines. Mm. And Supreme grabbed the mic and said, "This is dedicated to Fat Cat. We're toasting Fat Cat in prison."
Oh, that's gangster.
And that's online. That's as gangster as you get.
Let me ask you something. Like the oldest fucking trope or fucking cliche is like the young cats don't respect the old cats, or they act wild or some shit like that. Somebody like Fat Cat, who's been away for fucking 30 years. What type of welcome do you think he's going to get? Yeah, yeah.
If he had not cooperated, they would throw a parade for him. But
no shit.
The cooperation aspect, you know, shades the issue. And but if he was like Supreme, when Supreme came home for that 5-6 years, I mean, he was royalty.
Mm.
You know, he was running around with Jay-Z and Irv Gotti and Ja Rule. And at that time, Murder, Inc. was the biggest rap label in the game. Biggie had died. Murder, Inc. had kind of taken the Bad Boys spot at the top of the hip hop. Tree and they everywhere they went, they were running around with Supreme, and the red carpet got rolled out. And Fat Cat, again, if he hadn't cooperated, was even bigger than Preem. So if Fat Cat had not cooperated and he was coming home right now, it would be a very, very celebrated ordeal. But because of his cooperation, he's probably got to be a little bit more covert, and hopefully he'll learn, for his sake at least, maybe not. The victims' families might not think this, but hopefully he'll learn from what happened to Alpo and keep a low profile.
Yeah, I get like, what percentage of these big time dope dealer gangster cats do cooperate? It seems like a high percentage to me, right?
I'd have to tell you that in my 20 years or 15 years of studying this stuff, you think, you know, the way that the narrative is played out in pop culture, you think that it's the exception to the rule, but in fact, it's probably the rule. Most people cooperate. People that you don't even know that are cooperating. They're called, you know, dry informants or dry snitches, which means that you can cooperate and cut deals with the government, get paid for your information, but you're never going to take the stand. You'll never be outed as an informant. So I people that you don't know that are informants are most likely informants.
I feel like that's 80% of these motherfuckers. That's my like in my brain. And I think that came with them giving out those fucking crazy sentences and the RICO charges becoming like the. I think RICO and cooperation kind of go. To me, they go hand in hand. Tell me, am I wrong?
Of course, yeah, yes, absolutely. But now it's become inverted, and this is more so with the Italians than with the African American underworld, but. It's become a situation now where they're using the big fish to catch the smaller fish. You know, Joe Massino was the biggest Italian mafia godfather in New York City, maybe in America, from 1990 until the early to mid 2000s. And he flipped and made them or helped them take down all of his underlings. And I'm thinking to myself, so all the underlings are now going to prison, most of them for the rest of their lives. But the guy they were taking orders from is going to be able to get out in 5 or 10 years.
That's crazy, dog. That's wild as fuck, man. I can't even wrap my head around that.
It's called prosecutors and FBI agents want heads on their wall. Mm. And if you can say you were the FBI agent or you were the U.S. prosecutor to flip Joe Massino, it doesn't matter that he's walking out 5 or 10 years later. It matters that you've just taken your career and skyrocketed it. You can do whatever you want to write your ticket.
It's actually kind of smarter because, like, you get the bragging rights, you get more people, and this person's virtually crippled in a lot of ways.
And I'll quote, to play off what you said about the Racketeering Act or the RICO Act, which is just a way to make it so you don't actually have to pull the trigger. You don't have to give out the extortionate loan. You don't have to shake down the pizza parlor owner. You don't have to be the one that's booking the bet. But if you're the one that's benefiting from all that, you're going down with the same people that did it. And that didn't exist until 35 years ago. So I think the quote that sums it up best is there was a Chicago mobster named Joey the Clown Lombardo, and they caught him on tape talking about, now that the FBI is in the U.S. Attorney's Office are using RICO, how it, for them, it's a losing cause. He said they can convict a cheeseburger on a RICO. I mean, bro, go to McDonald's, put a cheeseburger on a plate. A U.S. prosecutor can take that and convict that cheeseburger of racketeering. That's how easy it. That it's like, you know, shooting fish in a barrel.
It seems crazy to me. I'm not crazy about that law, but you know, fuck. Well, now that we're on the subject of Italian mafia, didn't they discover a bunch of shit in Nevada?
Well, there's bodies popping up in Las Vegas, man. The last 2 weeks.
What?
There's been two bodies that are most likely mob hit victims from the 80s and the reign of Tony the Ant Spilotro, who people will know from the movie Casino. That's Joe Pesci's character. He was a real life person in the film. He was called Nicky Santoro, but in real life, his name was Tony Spilotro. But that movie was very accurate, unlike The Irishman. That movie was very accurate in the way that Joe Pesci portrayed Tony Spilotro was the way Tony Spilotro was. And Lake Mead, which is the big lake outside of Las Vegas, is having issues where the water is coming to the surface, and it's beaching a lot of marine life, but it's also beaching barrels with bodies in them. They found one the last day or two of April, and they just found one on Saturday. And the barrel, at least the first one, the barrel had that, you know, the guy's the body might be pretty much gone. They're just with bones, but they found their clothes, and you can identify what era it is by the clothes they were wearing. And the first guy they found had these shoes that were only sold at JCPenney. And they were only manufactured between 1978 and 1984. So you have a time frame.
That's wild. Well, I guess he deserves to die if he was wearing JCPenney shoes, man.
I remember a couple years ago, they dug up a body in Providence, Rhode Island, that had been there since the early 90s. And all that was left was a aqua blue Sergio Tacchini jogging suit.
Bro. It's fun. I got that motherfucker. I got that bitch hanging up in my motherfucking. I got the aqua blue boy hanging up in my
straight
closet
out of May,
right
1993.
Now. Straight up, that is wild. All right, 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. If you got any questions for Scott or comments or anything like that, call up right now. 888-742-3345. So, I saw a documentary on the casino shit, and I was surprised how closely Scorsese kept to the script of like what happened.
You know, both Goodfellas and Casino, he did not take a ton of creative license.
No.
He told those stories in the way that he told them and made them exactly what they were.
Well, the truth,
gussy it up.
I was going to say the truth is interesting, bro. Like, the truth is interesting. When you tell the fucking truth, that shit is fucking wild.
And that's why, for me, that was why it was hard for me to reconcile what he was doing with the Irishman. Because he'd been so true to the facts in Casino and Goodfellas, and then he was stretching the facts so much for the Irishman, it didn't make sense to me.
I know it's kind of fucked up because he sets this precedent of doing like real life movies that stick to the real life, and then boom, he comes out with the Irishman, and now I gotta listen to fucking Chinese restaurant talk of it being real. I'm just like, this is not
now
right,
it's in the ether now. And
yeah,
it's coming from Scorsese. It's coming from De Niro. So everyone thinks it's of course it's the truth.
Well, bro, if you really want to write history, just make a movie about that shit. And everybody takes the movies for being the truth. And it's like, I don't really know if that's 9 times out of 10, it doesn't go down the way it does in the movies. What's that? Go ahead, bro.
I said, the people I talked to that knew Tony Spilotro, the Joker character, they said that the portrayal was 99% perfect. They said the only thing that was off was how much he swore.
Wow.
But, you know, that he didn't throw out, you know, motherfuck, you know, as much as he does in the movie. I think in that film, he might say the word fuck or motherfuck more. I think I read this somewhere. Yeah. It was either the first or second most times in movie history.
And I'm guessing Goodfellas is one of the, it's probably tied with like Goodfellas and in Casino are like head to head with Pesci.
But yeah, so some of his guys were like, yeah, they portrayed him accurate, almost perfect. The only thing that was a little off was that he had such a dirty mouth.
But that kind of makes him even scarier to me, dog. Like this motherfucker, he ain't cussing or nothing. He's just taking lives. He's just like,
and screwing his best friend's girlfriend. Or wife.
Yeah, she was fucking everybody. Let's be real. But he shouldn't have done it. He shouldn't have fucking done it. John, who we got?
Let's go with Randy in D.C.
Randy, go ahead, man. You got Scott.
Hey, Scott. Hey, Jew, man. Thanks for calling. Thanks for picking up the line. Hey, just had a quick question. I used to always glorify the Italian mafia, just that whole lifestyle, until I started getting more knowledge about the demonic side to it. So, like, do you have any stories or any history about that, like the rituals they had to do to denounce their religion? And stuff like that, because it seems like there's a lot of demonic stuff that's tied behind it that's not showed on the spotlight.
I don't know if I would say it's demonic, but I know what you're saying. They do renounce religion. Their religion, when they take an oath to join the mafia, they're saying the mafia, the family that I'm joining, is now my religion. It comes before God. It comes before my family. They actually have to say that in the ritual that they undergo that's been going on for over 100 years. In America, it's been going on since 1931. But it's, they're denouncing their allegiance to their family and to any higher power. They're saying that the mafia is my God.
So it is blasphemous when you become a made man. The ritual is blasphemous. Is that the only ritual like that?
Well, and then you also have to. One of the things they say to you, like verbatim, is if your mother's dying, if your daughter's dying, if your wife's dying, and you're at her bedside, and I call you, what are you going to do? And if you don't say I'm going to leave to come see you, they kill you on the spot. So. That's how serious that ritual, that oath is.
No shit. 888-742-3345.
Got Poe in Detroit.
Poe.
What up, though?
You got it, bro. Go ahead, man.
Hey, Scott, what you think is the most proficient, like, successful underground crew in the Detroit drug game in the 70s and 80s?
In the 70s and 80s, who was the most underrated?
No, proficient, like YBI, friend, you know, like...
Proficient, in the 70s, you know, YBI was the ones that were getting all the headlines in the late 70s, early 80s. But really, the straw that was stirring the drink that not a lot of people know about was DFG, the Davis Family Gang, or the Davis Family Group. And they were international. So everybody that was copping in Detroit... If you weren't copping from the Italians, you were copping from DFG. So Reggie Doc Davis, his brother Dwayne Skinny D Davis, and it was a very efficient organization. And it was small, it was durable, it was pretty much all family. They had a presence on all five continents. So YBI was the one that were getting all the headlines and the ones that were making all the waves on the street. But the guy behind the guy behind the guy was Doc Davis.
That's wild as fuck. Now, where in Detroit were they located?
Doc was out of Doc was like West Side and East Side. I think he was mostly West Side, but he was supplying all the guys on the East Side.
Wow. I didn't know about that.
And, you know, a good example of sentencing disparities in the war on drugs. So when guys like White Boy Rick and other people from that era, the late 80s, early 90s, they got hit with really, really harsh sentences. You know, they called basketball sentences or football sentences, like, because they're the scores of basketball and football games.
Right.
But the guys in the 70s and early 80s, before the war on drugs really went into high gear, those guys got very lenient sentences. The YBI guys, nobody, YBI got the, at that time, was the biggest drug bust, I think, in Detroit history. And nobody did more than 5 years, 6 years, as opposed to all the guys that went down just 5, 6 years later were doing 20, 30, 40 years life.
That's wild as fuck. I didn't realize.
So Doc, Doc did 10 years.
So he was really doing shit because they gave him 10 years instead of five. That's why I didn't even know about those dudes until just now, man.
Yeah, you want to know? We'll throw in that? some Detroit radio. If people remember Reggie Reg,
yeah,
that's Doc Davis' son. That's Reggie Jr. That's Doc Jr.
Oh, I didn't know that. Oh, buddy.
Yeah.
That paints things a different picture. All right, there you go.
I grew up listening to Reggie Reg.
Yeah, that's my guy, bro. Who else is on the phone there, John?
Shelly in Maryland.
Shelly.
Hey, how you guys doing? I love the show. I want to know how relevant Snowfall is, and is it true that the government really did all of that to fund that war?
Yeah, I think they
Snowfall.
Yeah, Snowfall, yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's all true. And I tell you to also go watch the movie Kill the Messenger with Jeremy Renner.
Bro, they really bury that shit. I mean, fucking Freeway Rick Ross used to come on the show, and like this guy's story's crazy, but nobody in Hollywood would even touch him. It's like the government worked with Hollywood. It's crazy.
Yeah, and then this reporter who exposed it all, who Jeremy Renner plays in this film, died. And some people think it was suicide. Some people don't think it was suicide. So this guy lost his whole career and then lost his life because he exposed it. And it was out of state. I believe it was the San Jose Mercury. It wasn't even a major paper. It wasn't like the LA Times
Can you tell them briefly what they exposed? And like, cause I'm referring to Freeway and shit like that. Go ahead. Sorry.
The CIA was funding drug dealing in South Central and taking the profits from that drug dealing and funding the rebels in Nicaragua.
We're so crazy, dog. Fucking, this country
Freeway
is
Ricky
nuts,
Ross,
bro.
Was being used as an asset without realizing he was being used as a CIA asset. Because the guys he was copping from were actually CIA.
Whew, that's crazy. That's fucking nuts. So there you go.
And in the movie, Michael K. Williams, who played from The Wire and from Borderline Empire, he plays Freeway Rick Ross. He's really good in it.
888-742-3345. All right, let's do one last one.
All right, let's go with Mike in Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
Mike,
what's going on? Thanks for taking the call.
Awesome. Shit.
I had a question about the Russian mob, but what's their relevance these days? What sets them apart from the rest of the gang?
I mean, the Russians and the Albanians are, you know, in a category all by themselves, and it's very insular and it's very secluded to those neighborhoods, whether you're talking New York, Chicago, Detroit, other major cities. But they're active and they're powerful and they're violent. And I know in terms of the Italians, for the last 25 years, 30 years, a lot of Italian muscle work is farmed out to the Russians and Albanians.
I remember going, I often talk about this on the air, but I used to work at Lush during bar backing on Albanian house. Like, they used to play house on Saturdays, and it was just all Albanians. And those motherfuckers, they were a lot of vuv and then a lot of pistols at the end of the night. A lot of pistols and good tipping. That's all I remember.
Just know that that type of organized crime is more akin probably to the cartels as opposed to traditional Italian OC or African-American drug gangs. The Russians, the Albanians, the Mexican cartels, I mean, they just have zero... human life means nothing. It's very reckless and very volatile, and it's not like one or two people get killed. It's like hundreds of thousands of people get killed.
There it is. Scott Burnstein, are you still doing, you're not doing the podcast no more, or what are you doing?
Yeah, I'm still doing the podcast, OG Original Gangsters podcast. You can get them anywhere you consume podcasts. I actually have an interview with Doc Davis from a couple weeks ago. You can check out. He talks all about his run as the head of DFG and how he's come back to Detroit over since he got out of prison 25 years ago and is now is a respected businessman and community leader. Owns a lot of real estate. Owns a lot of other businesses. So he's really flipped the script and wrote a great second chapter. I'm working on the Black Mafia Family show that's on Stars, which is a Detroit story. And there's going to be a docuseries that I'm really excited about. That's going to be a complimentary to the scripted series. And that's it's going to roll out soon this summer. And it's 8-part docuseries that I'm behind the scenes on. And I'm also in front of the camera. So if you like the scripted show, Black Mafia Family, that was a really big hit this past fall, and it's now the second season shooting. This is telling you the real story from the real people. Big Meech and all of Big Meech's lieutenants and all the FBI agents and guys that that you saw on screen this past fall are all going to be telling their stories in docuseries form. That's going to kind of buffer between season one scripted and season two scripted. You're going to have this docuseries out this summer that I'm excited to promote.
I'm really looking forward to that. That sounds awesome, bro. That sounds great.
And then we're digging for Jimmy Hoffa in a couple of weeks. So check that out. I'll be back on to talk about that.
Oh, word. All right, bet. Who the fuck knew? You've been busy, Scott. You've been fucking busy. I love it, man.
It's a History Channel thing where they're going to be digging it, or they're going to dig at a site in New Jersey at some point in the next month. And the History Channel is going to like follow me around as they're digging. So it should be interesting.
All right, man. I already got questions for it. Like, just you telling me that, I'm already
like,
they
ain't going to find them. There ain't nothing to be found.
Like that, and that's my question. Look, we'll come back on and I'll ask you all the questions. I don't want to burn it down now. So, okay. All right, Scott, I appreciate you, man.
Thanks, guys.
All right, be well, Scott. That's Scott Burnstein. Fucking our expert on all of this shit. Let's go.
As I look up at the sky, my mind starts tripping, a tear drops my eye.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Shay 4-5. How you doing out there? My name is Jude, and I'm here to help you with your life. If you're having any type of problem, guy problem, girl problem, baby daddy, baby mama, work, parents, they just don't understand. Am I right? Right? Any type of problem you can think of, I want you to reach out and talk to the kiddo. I got your back. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345 is the number that you're going to call when it's time to talk to me. And that time is now. So call up right now. 888-742-3345. It's What Would You Do? And it is coming up next.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
It's like a ray of light beaming down knowledge from the heavens above.
What would you do? You need advice?
Call us up right now.
Now. 888-SHAVE-45. What would you do?
Shave 45.
Hey, what up, though? It's your boy, Judy. I'm here to help you. Call up right now, 888-742-3345. You got any type of problem in your life, I'm your man. Right, John, who we gonna talk to?
Pri in North Carolina.
Hey, Pri.
Hey, Judy.
What seems to be your trouble today?
All right, my trouble is I just started a new job. It's been maybe 5 months. I tried to befriend this girl as like a friend, like little sister type. And she just seems like every other day she has a problem with me. One day she wants to be friends. One day she is a bitch. Today she hit me with the, oh, you got a two-family income household, so my life is harder than yours. And I'm like, well, first of all, it ain't my fault the nigga asked me to marry him and I said yes. Or it ain't my fault. Ain't nobody asked you to marry you.
She sounds awful. Like, fuck this chick. No,
bro,
fuck her.
Like, shit pissed me off.
Don't even talk to her. She knew better. She do better. Here's the deal, man. Like, if anybody starts comparing themselves to you, just fucking walk. Like, you don't need that shit.
You know what I'm saying, bro? I don't even do that. I don't even like comparing myself to nobody because I don't feel like I'm better than nobody. We all get it out here in the mud. You know what I'm saying? Times is hard on everybody. Like, I ain't fucking complaining to her that I don't get food stamps, you know?
Bro, she sound like a loser. That's loser talk. Because here's the deal. If you trying to win, you focusing on you. You're not looking at nobody else. If you're looking at anybody else, it's just for fucking to give you some drive. You dig what I'm saying? Like, all right, I see what they doing over there. Let me step my... If you look at anybody else, it's so that you step your fucking game up. She ain't trying to do that shit. She's looking at you and throwing a fucking pity party. Fuck her. She's no good. You don't need to befriend her. You're not going to put her up on game. She's a fucking boring loser. And she ain't going to fight. Like, she's going to have to come up. She's going to have to get hit with an epiphany for her to change that mind the way she's thinking, dog. Like, fuck her, dog.
Man, I fucking love you, man.
I love you too. And like, yo, anything you got, you deserve. And anything she got, she deserve. And that's the way it fucking goes. So fuck her. Who's next, John? Oh man, that chick pissed me off just hearing about her. You got this and I don't got that. Like, shut the fuck up and focus on winning.
I've got Tony in Connecticut.
Lame bitch. Tony.
Hey, what's up, dude?
Shit, Selen, what is your problem today?
So, I'm married. I got an almost 2-year-old kid. I'm with my wife. She don't really accept me for who I am. I don't really know how to go about getting out of it and how about having a healthy family.
What do you mean she doesn't accept you for who you are? Like, what doesn't she like about you, just out of curiosity?
We've been together for a long time, and I kind of fucked up in the beginning of our relationship, and it's kind of carried through up until now. We've been together 14 years. I've been married to her for 3. We have a kid at 2 now. She had a miscarriage, which was like devastating, before my child right now, which got us really close. And then, I don't know, man, I love her. I respect her. She's a great woman. I know she could have better than me.
What the fuck does that mean?
I don't know how to go about.
Nah, you shouldn't think like that. She can have better than you. Why don't you work on just being a good you? Do you not want to be with her? Do you just not want to be with your wife? And that's some cop out.
I don't think so. It's just hard at times.
She could have better than me. Shut up, dog. Sounds like you're throwing a pity party, dog. Like, what the fuck? She let you come in her, and she's having your child. So, like, what, like, I don't, like, does she tell you that she can have better than you? Is she downgrading you or some shit, or what?
Like, when we're with people, sometimes she'd be like, and that's what's, like, hard for me to take in, is that, you know, she's good to me when it's me and her, and then, you know, around other people, she's more educated than I am, and... You know, not that that means anything to me, that it doesn't separate us in that manner, but she kind of holds her in a higher respect than me, I guess.
You don't check her when she fucking talks down on you in front of other people? You're a beaten down man, bro. Nah, fuck that, dog. No, you don't let that shit go. There's shit you don't let go. That shit does not ride, dog. You don't talk down to, you don't fucking shit on her in front of other people, and she doesn't shit on you in front of other people. And if that person does do that, you fucking check them, dog.
So, like, here's my question to you. Like, I don't know what to do with my family moving forward. I don't know what steps to take. Like, I still want to be able to have, like, interaction with my wife, but I just don't think me and her are meant to be with each other.
Yo, dog, like, clearly she doesn't sound like the best person, or she's got some fucking underlying anger towards you because she's fucking shitting on you in public. I don't know where you're going to go with this shit, but you need to fucking, you need to address all that shit. Like, you can't just be, well, you're going to be a chump for the next chick, too? And the more she shits on you, the less she respects you. What'd you do? You, like, cheated a long time ago? When'd you cheat?
Because I cheated on her. She knows a lot about my past. Like, we've been together.
When?
I mean, she knew a lot about.
How did he get out?
When, what? When did I cheat on her?
Yeah.
Oh, in the beginning of our relationship. Sorry about that.
10 years ago, you cheated on her?
Yeah.
And she's still walking around with that shit?
Yep.
All right, man. You got to talk to her and be like, yo, I know that, like, we had some bumps and shit, but, like, I'd give her an ultimatum, or I'd be like, hey, man, I know we had some problems, but, like, you can't keep carrying that shit around, and you can't keep treating me like this in front of other people. And if she doesn't like that, then go. Leave.
All right.
I mean, but you got to fucking, like, come on, bro. You got to talk to her, man. Like, she over here just beasting on you, and you just take it, have another drink, and she's shitting on you in front of people? Come on, man. Where's your self-respect?
I guess it's good to hear from you.
Have some fucking dignity, bro. You deserve it, man. All right, you know what? You deserve whatever the fuck you get, man. So if you can let your girl shit on you in front of people and don't do nothing about it, that's exactly what you deserve, man. So why don't you work on deserving more? Who's next?
Sam in Jacksonville, Florida.
Ah, shit. Sam in Jacksonville.
Hey, Jude. Thanks for taking the time. I have a little problem. Back in January, I was celebrating my birthday with about 6 friends and my girlfriend at the time. And a man walked up and punched me right in the head, kind of out of nowhere. I was really taken off guard. Obviously, it turns out he bought my girlfriend a $5 drink. She was pretty hammered, and he thought he was going to flirt with her or get lucky. Anyway, she comes back over to our group of friends. He gets extremely upset, punches me in the head. Long story short, the cops called me, want to know if I want to press charges against the guy, and I don't know what to do.
How long ago was this?
It happened in January.
I don't know. Do you feel like pressing charges? Do you feel like going to court?
Well, the thing that I am struggling with is that, you know, it happens to happen in front of my girlfriend, who's my fiance now. He punched me in the head a couple times. I ended up having to get stitches. So I'm a little embarrassed. Obviously, I don't want my woman to think I'm a little bitch. So I'm trying to decide if pressing charges is going to make me look like more or less of a man.
It'll make you look like more of a bitch. You're going to look like a bitch. Come on, man. You're going to be in fucking court. You're going to be in court pointing at that guy. You know what I mean? Like, he did it. You know what I mean? Like, what happened? Well, he punched me twice and I didn't do any. You know what I mean? Like, you know, bro, you want to keep reliving this shit?
You're going to have to. I just want to make sure this kind of guy doesn't do this shit again. I don't know.
Tell your girl not to be accepting drinks from fucking men while she's out with you.
Hey, it's $5, man. You can't turn down a free drink.
Well, you get socked in the fucking head for it then.
Yeah, I guess.
There's so many parts of this story where you don't look like that much of a man. You don't even realize that shit. Now, like, I get it. Like, I used to have my girl... you know, let dudes buy her drinks because I was on some fucking use a chick shit. But I outgrew that, and like now I'm my own man, and I don't really have a strong stance on it one way or the other, but I know this much: if my girl does get a drink bought for her, I'm not going to get punched in the head afterwards. I'll tell you that right now. And if I do, I'll probably just let it go, or I'll try to catch him on a rebound. But like, I'm not going to court for that shit. Just look, bro. Like, I don't think you understand like all that what pressing charges is entails, man.
John, yeah, I know. John would press and point with the guy.
Yeah.
And
yeah, like I think John would press charges. John would actually box him back because John's a boxer.
I would fuck that guy up.
See,
someone's getting hurt.
But John would let his girl fucking shit on him in public like the other dude did. Like, so yeah.
I don't know. I wouldn't like it.
All right, John. Like, I'm a yeah, exactly. I wouldn't like it. I'd have another gin.
Gee, Sally.
What would you do in this dude's shoes?
All right, in this particular case, at this point in my life, I would have punched that guy right in the face. We're both getting kicked out. Someone's getting hurt. That's a fact.
So, all right, that being said, you didn't do it. Right. Like, let's say it just went down the way it went down with him. Where
would I press charges
in the head?
No. Yeah. No. I mean, I already left. It's already a done deal. I mean, if I was suffering like serious eye damage or something.
Yeah. If you're like retarded or some shit afterward, you got brain damage.
But otherwise, fuck it. No, just learn from it and move on.
Even John's not pressing charges, dog. If that happens to John, he's not pressing charges. What do you think about that now? Do you still want to press charges?
I like John, but I don't necessarily want to be John. So no.
Yeah, I'm not pressing charges. No, none of us are pressing charges except for you. Like, I'm just like when old boy fucking broke into my place and I had to fight him. Like, it's like, bro, I don't want to go to fucking court. I don't care. I don't care if he does it again. What the fuck? Do you really think that's going to deter him from doing it again once he gets out of and nothing's going to happen to him? It's a fucking misdemeanor or maybe a light felony. I don't even know what the fuck you'd be charged with. So, just let it go, bro. And look, man, everybody ain't going to whoop everybody. But, man, you really got to get your girl in line.
I'll work on it.
I'm selling you. You giggling, bro. She's the one that got you punched in the fucking head.
Yeah, I mean, she wasn't soliciting the drink. She just happened to be standing there. A dude bought her a drink, and then she was like, oh, thanks, but no thanks. And then he got all butthurt about it and decided to puff up a little bit.
All right. So, I'm just saying. You know, whatever. All right. Or at least give you a fucking heads up, like, hey, I had a problem with that dude over there, so it wouldn't be no fucking sucker punching. All right. There's so much weird. That story's so weird to me.
Yeah, I think she was talking to the guy more than he's letting on.
Yeah, that's what I think too, bro. All
right.
And like, it's like she stood there and waited for him to get the drink. You dig?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Yeah, she was real put upon. Like, get the fuck out of here.
Mike in Dallas.
Mike.
Dude. Dating a girl with a kid with special needs. How you feel about that?
What's that? You're dating a girl with I don't know. Do you like her?
With a kid. I do, man. I like her a lot. But I've never been in a situation like that.
Like, how special are the needs? Like, the kid, like, she's going to be taking care of him when he's 50?
He's got autism.
Oh, so like,
that's what I'm saying.
Go.
I don't know. I mean, I think it's going to be like that, yeah.
I don't know. Look, I don't think you're out of line for talking to her about it. You know what I mean? So that you know what the fuck you're getting into, dog. Like, no, he's gonna, like, that's like, you know, I barely want to date a chick with a kid or a puppy. You know what I mean? Let alone a kid or a kid that needs more attention than the average kid. It just depends on what type of person you are. And also, like, like I said before, it is fair to ask her that. Be like, hey, you know, like, tell her, be like, hey, I like you, but like, I don't know what I'm getting into. Like, and say just that, like, I like you a lot, but I don't know what I'm getting into. Like, is your kid going to be with you like forever? Is this like a, or are they going to go off on their own, or, you know, like, is he going to go to a assisted living? Like, these are all, like, I think these are fair questions to ask, dog.
Yeah, yeah, you're right, because she's talked about stuff like that before too, you know, so I just didn't,
what,
you know, ask about, you know,
what stuff has she talked about? What do you mean, what stuff?
She said she used to work at an assisted living, in an assisted living place where she had to take care of adults that had that kind of situation, where they were pretty much out on their own. They had their own little place, but they also had 24-hour care. Like, somebody would be there all day, and she was one of those people. And she said she couldn't take it because she was getting attached to the people and stuff like that.
Doesn't that sound like she kind of like, bro, like... it sounds like she's open to talking about it. Like, sounds like she might have even been hoping that you would broach that subject with her and her child right there. Who the fuck knows? So yeah, just like find out what you're dealing with, and then you can make a decision whether or not you want to fucking be with her. That's it.
Yeah, yeah. I need to
and
have,
bro,
that discussion.
There's no wrong answer on this. You know what I mean? If you don't want to deal with it, that's cool. And if you're down to fucking participate in this with her, that's great too. You know, like, I don't want you, don't do anything out of fucking guilt.
Yeah, that's true.
And if you're not gonna fuck with her like that, and it's gotten to this far, you might want to work on not getting too fucking close before one of y'all get your feelings hurt.
That's what I mean. Yeah,
because
I'm kind of right there.
All right, man. It's go time now, dog. Fucking talk to her. Y'all got to talk talk to who you're with, people. You got to communicate with them. If you got some shit on your mind, fucking talk to them. So much of these problems are just like, you're not talking to your fucking girl. You're not talking to your dude. Who's next?
Lavonda in Greenville, South Carolina.
Hey, Lavonda.
Hey, how you doing?
Fucking, I'm all right. What about yourself?
I'm pretty good.
Okay.
Hey, I was calling because I was messing with a guy at work and nobody really knows. And my boss lady is trying to sleep with my man. And I'm about ready to knock her out.
But she don't know. Why are you going to knock her out?
She don't know.
Well, you can't knock you can't knock somebody out for being ignorant to facts. And like, what the fuck is your man doing? Like, what's your man doing? Like, is he flirting with her? Like, maybe you need to check.
No, he ain't flirting with her. And he told her, you know, he don't want her like that. And he told her, like, she need to fix herself up. You know, she don't clean up nice. And she got hair on her face and stuff like that. He say he don't like her, but she won't stop asking him out every weekend.
Well, as long as he's not doing anything, I don't think there's a problem. And if it's that much of a big deal, like, he can go talk to HR that he's being sexually harassed. Like, but you need to stay the fuck out of it, especially if you're trying to keep it on the low. You know what I mean?
Right, right.
Like, he's a man. He should be able to handle it. You know what I mean? He's a dude.
Yeah.
I fucking hope he can handle a lady hitting on him. Even if it is
right. I'm yeah, she done gave him a credit card and everything. Tell him if he need anything, just use that credit card on me.
Wait, hold up. He took the credit card?
Yeah, because, you know, she done gave it to him before, and he gave it back. And now they keep insisting that he has one, so...
Wait, hold up.
He got it all.
I don't think it's a good idea that your man is taking gifts from this woman that he doesn't want anything to do with.
Right.
Whether she's buying shit for you or he's buying shit for you or not. Like, it's just, he can't be like, don't fuck with me, but I'll take your money. Like, that's,
right.
He's giving her mixed signals. So, like I said, your man, like, talk to your dude. Talk to your man. And actually, tell him to stop telling you about this shit, too. You don't need to stress out about it. You know he's not going to fuck her. So fuck her. And she ain't doing nothing disrespectful to you because you don't exist in this fucking situation because you're a secret. All right, who's? Let me get one last one.
Jay in Connecticut.
Jay!
Yo!
What up, though?
What up, though? What up, though? Long time listener, first time caller. But listen, man, Jew, all my friends are fucking simps. You know what I'm saying? So when I talk to them, it don't get nowhere. So I'm gonna ask you. I be, you know, fumbling it around in my head. I had a girl I was talking to about 4 years ago. She deaded me. You know what I'm saying? I wasn't on my shit then. Wasn't on my shit too much, Jew. Right. Now, 2022, I'm a little bit up, a little bit better situation than what I was then. Now she want to talk to you, dude. What would you do? She want me back, Jew. What would you do?
Well, you already said you said it yourself. You wasn't about what you weren't living up to your potential. Is that fair to say?
Right.
A few years ago, you weren't living up to your potential. Who would want to be like? I wouldn't want to be with a chick that's not living up to her potential, and she's not even the breadwinner.
Was fucked up.
Well, then it sounded like y'all needed to step away from each other because you guys were gonna end up like Beavis and Butthead, just hyping each other up to do dumb fucking things. So where's she at now?
Let me ask you this.
Yeah.
Let me ask you this though, like. Throughout the 4 years, though, while I was getting my shit together, you know, getting myself right, she would throw in my face all the guys she would talk to, da-da-da-da-da-da. Because, mind you, we still got a lot of people we associate with, so right. We know each other business type thing. You know what I'm saying? So throughout all that, it was like, hey, I deaded your ass 4 years ago. Now every step of the way, when I get a new dude, I'm throwing it in your face type shit. It don't work out. 4 years later, down the line, now I see you, I want you. Should I get her back? Should I give her a chance to...
I mean, if you want to, like, look, bro, this sounds like it sounds like there's layers to this that you're really not even telling me. I don't think it's that big of a deal. Like, it's like when I look, man, I'll put it like this. Back in the day, I was fat. None of the girls wanted to fuck with me. Then I lost weight and I started getting all these girls. And I was angry at them. I had all of these girls for hollering at me now, and they didn't like me when I was fat. But like, let's be real, I didn't even like me when I was fat. So I had to stop being mad at fucking people, mad at women. So perhaps you was on some loser shit. Now you're not on loser shit, and she sees that in you. And if she's not on loser shit, then great. Now, was she trying to make you jealous or I don't know. I don't know what her motive was, her telling you this shit, the dudes that she fucked with. And to be quite frank, if you didn't want to hear about it, you should have told her not to tell you about that shit.
Nah, but it wasn't like me necessarily asking. It was like, I'll throw it in your face. Hi here, motherfucker. I got a new boyfriend. Throw it on your Facebook page. Hi here, motherfucker. I got your phone number still. I'm going to take a picture while I'm out at the park, skipping and holding hands with the motherfucker.
Nah. All right, man. Dog, I wouldn't fuck with her then. On that, I wouldn't.
You know what I'm saying? Little light shit like that. Little light shit.
Yeah, that's weird, man. Like, that's fucking weird. I'm more understanding somebody like not fucking with you because you're not doing your best, because you're, I don't know, fucking off all the times, going out every goddamn night, not saving money. Like, I can see somebody not fucking with you off of that, but they don't need to be fucking sending you pictures of them and other dudes the whole fucking time. That's a weird, nah, man. Nah, bro. No.
I'm saying that's some foul shit, and that's why I'm trying to wrap my head around it, because, like, okay, you done, it's been, about 4 years removed, 4 or 5 years. You done had 4 or 5 dudes removed since then. And I known every nigga you done talked to because you done threw it in my face. Yeah, now, no. It didn't work out. Drew, this is why you need it, my man. This is why you need it, my man. Because these simp-ass dudes up in Connecticut, they think, oh, you know, make it better, you know, get back together type thing, and you know, oh, it's 4 years ago. Fuck it. It's 2020. Man, fuck that. It's the principle of shit. You know what I'm saying? What happened to the principle of shit? That's what I'm trying to figure.
You know what they say, a leopard ain't going to change his stripes. Ace, like, nah, dog. No. You, no. I wish she would. And it sounds like you liked her enough where you can't even, like, fuck her just to, you know, be spiteful, because you're going to end up in your feelings off of that shit. So, yeah, just leave her the fuck alone. Don't waste your time with her. All right. I solved the world's problems. I'm done. Let's play some music. Come on back.
Listening to the All Out Show with you.
Shade 45. Listen to the All Out Show, y'all. I want to thank you. We're number one. Well, I don't know what number we are here, but I know that that you, the listeners, because I've only been talking about it here and on my Instagram, you, the listeners, have made the Audible of Finn number one new release. Appreciate you. Like, for just, for like a week now, bro. Fucking dope. And if you already bought the book, you should really listen to me read that shit. It's a different feel. And then I, at the end of the book, I'll tell you behind the scenes of all the stories. Like they did on DVDs back in the day. Boom.
Bonus tracks.
Fuck yeah, special features type shit. I don't think any other Audible book has done that yet. I'm surprised they haven't. Don't seem like just the natural thing to do, but like, I don't fucking know. Anyway, grab Finn for free with the trial at Audible. Boom. John, what are we going to talk about?
Some pointers when it comes to anal sex.
This is the news, by the way. It's not just me and him are going to talk about anal sex.
Get a cup of coffee later.
Yeah, let's have some coffee and you can fucking fill me in about anal sex, John. Fuck yeah, sounds good.
Also, will Mike Tyson face charges for his dust up on the plane recently?
That's when he socked that kid in the head a couple times. Who had it coming?
He needed it.
Let's be real. Yeah, I think 9 out of 10 people felt that that kid had it coming. That kid might even feel like that. Looking back, who the fuck knows? What else?
Then I'll say,
I don't care. I don't care. Boom, let's go. We got the news next. Boo. All Out Show. Bam.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you. And now, it's time for News from the Chin with John Z. Matthews.
I have five very important things you always need to do after anal sex.
I know one of them.
What's that?
Wipe the shit off your dick.
Ah.
Is this for the dude that's plowing the chick?
It's for both.
All right, for both? Okay. Yeah.
First of all,
was that on there? Shit off your dick?
Negative.
That's a fucking, really?
It's sort of Jesus. Understood. I think that's just kind of common sense.
Oh, you know, you never know.
Switch condoms if you plan to go from the anus to the badge. You got to do it. Have you ever done that?
Bro, it was crazy. One of my exes sodomizing her. As one does, you know what I mean? Sure. And then swapped over to the vagina without doing anything. And we ended up burning each other, basically. Yuck. Like with a crazy, like we were both burning. We thought the other person was cheating. And then it just
turned out to be an infection.
Turned out just to be a dirty sex. Yeah.
Well, that's because.
That happened on Valentine's. Bad Valentine's.
Wow. Yeah. How old were you again?
Shit, 21, something uh-huh. like that.
All right. You'd think you'd know by then, but.
No one ever is like, hey, clean your dick off. Like, this, you know, this is a fucking, it's not like now, you know?
Right.
Where, like, everybody's watching porn all the fucking time. Like, it was a different time back then.
That always sort of puzzles me in porn when I've seen that, where I guess it's hot when the guy goes from the ant, from the ass to the vagina to the ass, back and forth. Like, hey,
Yeah, I think the same shit, too. I'm like, what, y'all didn't get the memo, dog? Like, the other thing, too, is, and I like fucking, you know me, I love degradation, but it doesn't make me happy to see a dude bang a chick in the butt and then have her blow him. That kind of bums me out,
yes,
bro.
Absolutely.
I'm just like, ugh. And I usually switch. I'm like, and I'm good on that. Let me find a new one. Ugh.
Ugh. There's nothing happy.
They probably, that's another thing they probably say. Don't suck his dick after he's been fucking you.
Oh. I mean, of course, you got things to worry about, like E. coli. You don't want to suck on that E. coli.
For real, dog? E. coli. That's fucking awesome. All right.
For lubrication, silicone lubes are typically recommended for anal since they're more durable. Now, they're also trickier to clean up than water-based lubes, so you might need to take extra steps to freshen up.
That's my go-to lube, bro.
Silicone-based?
Oh, bro, it's the best.
It's really that much of a difference? Okay.
Yeah, man. Water-based lube gets sticky, dog. Like, it's... water-based lube gets sticky. Silicone goes and goes.
Well, if you're really into the anal life, then consider keeping baby wipes on hand or hopping in the shower for a post-anal scrub.
I think, I think hitting the bathroom afterwards is better than fucking a baby wipe, dog.
Yeah, that seems, doesn't really get it done.
Yeah, bro, like you, man, if you need a baby wipe, you wasn't even putting in work like that, you know? After I fuck a girl, we gotta go to the bathroom. Go wipe that shit off. Wash it off. Soap and water.
Some effort.
You dig?
So now, after the anal, there's a good chance you're going to feel and sound gassier than normal because your sphincter muscles could be loose after the fact. You might not be able to control the gusts of flatulence that need to come out.
It's okay. Yeah, don't be ashamed. It's okay, ladies.
What? Really? You're not actually farting, as they say here. It's just your body's way of expelling the air that is trapped during the pounding.
Eh. Whatever you want to call it. Yeah. It's a weird noise.
And also, of course, don't forget your Kegel exercises. And that's because you're weakening your anal sphincter. I mean, if you do this all the time, again, if this is your go-to, you might have to start worrying about fecal incontinence.
Hmm.
Yikes.
I mean, like, wow, dog. Like, how much do you got to bang someone in the ass for their shit to just give up? Like, fuck it. It's done.
Well, again, not to refer back to porn, but those are where I see most of my assholes. And there's some ladies where it's just so obvious that they've done some real mileage down there, and it looks kind of weak. Damn.
The shit that fucking blows me away is when, like, after when they're doing it and he pulls out and it's like,
it's still open.
Bro, yeah, I feel like I can see the future in her asshole or some shit like that. That's
I have to look away.
Bro, that's crazy for me too. Like, damn, dog, like, yo, what the fuck? The fuck he got fucking
close that
up. Like, yeah, open it up. I mean, you're just like, nah, bro, shut that shit.
Yeah, even though you like degrading porn, anything with, like, gaping in the title, I just pass. Can't handle it.
Yo, dog, yeah, like, I like mental degradation, you dig? Like, I like somebody to be, like, mentally fucked. I don't, you know, like, show me your fucking ass. I'm like, yo, dog, no.
Well, and again, all right, okay, forgive me. Number five, keep an eye on, well, at least this is not really wiping your penis of the feces, because they're saying you're keep an eye on your poop, because your ass is not built for penetration, muscle fibers can be easily damaged, along with blood vessels, and you might be bleeding a bit. It could tear your ass.
So that's par for the course. That is par for the course. Be all right.
Don't want that.
Walk it off.
Well, this is good news. Mike Tyson will not face criminal charges over this airplane fracas he was involved with that dickhead, the guy from Florida.
Yeah, but old boy can still sue, can he?
You know, he was talking about that. I remember that. He had an attorney. The attorney was speaking publicly about, well, Mike should have slowed down. So, yes, he could file some sort of a private lawsuit here. But just based on this.
Bro, I don't like, he's already hated. I don't know if he wants to be the most hated. You know what I mean? Like, or he might not give a fuck and just be like, fuck it, I'm getting my money.
Well, okay, again, I don't want to pretend to know much about this. I've got a very short article about it, but the DA involved in San Mateo County said the conduct of the victim leading up to the incident, the interaction between Tyson and the victim, as well as the requests of both the victim and Mr. Tyson, no charges will be filed.
So, oh, the victim, all right, see, he's, for being a fucking dickhead, he's smart right there. Because I think he'd get a lot of backlash.
And he's not.
No one was on that kid's side.
No. Melvin George Townsend III from Punta Gorda. And again, he's got a rap sheet. He served 20 and 15 month prison sentences for, looks like he stole a trailer.
Sounds pretty methy to me, bro.
He served 15 months for use of a fake ID. He was charged with burglary, drug possession, tracking stolen goods. So him going into the court again.
Yeah. Well, it he probably, you know, look, man, he might have picked up something from jail. I feel like he's the type of dude that, like, will have his dad take him to go buy drugs and shit. I'd rather I do it than he be on his own, like that type of shit.
Gotta keep an eye on Melvin.
Fucking Melvin.
Wonder what he's up to. I did try to find him online, and I figured he had a Facebook page, but boy, I had to give up after a little bit.
I don't need to talk to that guy.
I know.
I'm not losing sleep, bro. Yeah. Oh, man. If only we could get Melvin. The fuck were you thinking? I guess it would turn into a hate it or love it, where people would just call up shitting on him, but, you know, whatever.
He seems like the kind of guy who would hang up on us, which I always hate. They get hurt and they disappear. Fuck you. Didn't Bagel Man hang up on us? I think he did.
Which one's Bagel Man?
The guy who lost it in the bagel shop years ago, the bagel boss. Remember that whole thing?
I don't remember, but yeah, all right. Never mind. He hung up.
He did.
I mean, that, like, can you blame them? That they don't have any. What's the incentive for them to stay on? Just to fucking argue and shit? They ain't got nothing to plug.
Yeah.
Why'd you hang up, you fucking pussy? You didn't want to be called a faggot 50 fucking times? Like, no, I don't think so.
Own it.
Come on, man. Boss up. Take that beating like a man.
All right, you will not like this. 1 in 3 people that were surveyed recently would choose their pet over their house or their spouse.
Over their house?
Mm-hmm. I don't know how that would play out.
What the fuck does that? Yeah, right. They're full of fucking shit. Sitting there homeless and shit, sharing a fucking can of Chef Boyardee with their dog? No fucking way, bro. Not a chance. I can see them giving up their spouse, though.
Really? Because, and I don't mean to seem super harsh here, but dogs, they live for like 11 years, 15 if you're lucky. I dig it, bro.
I feel you, man. Like, but it just, that seems to be the way things are going, man. Well, you see it in Cali all the fucking time. There's so many people that just, they have these little dogs that do not leave their side, bro.
Absolutely.
Like, they're with them all the fucking time. I think it's gross, but whatever. Like, chicks aren't even having kids. They're just fucking having dogs. And that's just what we need. More dogs will help with fucking paying taxes and shit. That's great, you know, huh?
One thing I haven't noticed, we had a bit of a dog scene going for a while before everybody went home, and thankfully the dogs have not returned. But again, I don't mean to seem cold. It just,
bro,
you know, leave the dogs at home.
Whatever, man. Me and you are both, like, me and you are both in that same camp. Like, bro, get the fuck. Like, I'm not fucking with no dogs, bro.
And there's one dog, it was always known for slobbering. It would come over. I was like, oh, man, dude, get a handle on this. But
shit, when I was in L.A., like, my homie, I ain't seen in a minute. Bro, that motherfucker got a dog, and he was he was showing me pictures like it was his kid, and I'm trying to be polite, but goddamn, he's got to know that I don't give a fuck about his animal, man. He's got to know that, right? Like, I changed the subject after like the third pick. My sister was there being all polite, and I just changed the subject as soon as I could. Fuck that. I don't care about your fucking dog.
There was some guy boxing a couple weeks ago showing everybody his dog pictures, and I was just staring at their faces, not so much the pictures. Just like, is it him? Are you guys really into this? Whatever.
Especially men. You know, I just expect different shit from men and women. I know we're all equal and shit, but like, it's one thing for a chick to be like, and here he is in his little sweater, and look, he's a bumblebee for Halloween. Like, I could, like, as opposed to like your homeboy, like, hey man, come over here, check out this whippet that I got. You know, it's, oh yeah, yeah, he was a rescue. Bro, I'm a fucking dude. You're a dude. Why are you showing me fucking animals? Unless we dog fighting or some shit like that. But that's another thing, you know.
That's a whole other thing, the dog fighting.
Those are the only people I could see showing, like somebody that breeds pits or some shit like that, and he's showing off a dog for me to buy or something. Other than that, like, fuck that.
All right, but again, another 31% of the people say that the possibility of their pet's death keeps them up at night, even more so than the death of a family member.
What's wrong? Oh, man, I was just thinking if Snoopy died, I don't know what the fuck I'd do.
Yeah, looked a little confused today. I don't know what's going on.
I had an awful dream that you know, they'd be naming their dogs after rappers, that Jeezy died. And you're like, what the fuck? I'm like, come on, man. No. No. I don't know what happened to us, man. We are fucking... Like, I swear to God, just a minute ago, like, they had dog houses. Now we're straight up taking care of those fucking... Whatever. All right.
All right. This is a misleading headline, but I guess there is some truth to it. Top hair surgeon warns men too much masturbation can cause hair loss.
Nah, I don't believe that because you got a full head of hair, John.
And, you know, I'm out there masturbating.
Yeah, you a fuck. You're probably, you jerk off more than like somebody with Down syndrome at a home.
On certain days, I think that's absolutely true. And then I'd like, you know what, let's get outside. Let's jump some rope or something.
Yeah, something like that, bro. Yeah, you really get after it. It's just like, come on, bro.
What's going on?
Straight up, bro.
But this guy, he's a hair transplant surgeon, Dr. Yumir Ahmad, award-winning hair transplant surgeon. All right. And now he's saying for that to actually happen, though, because he's pointing to vitamin A, you'd have to really be doing it all the time. So, I mean, I'd have to be masturbating right now to give you a sense of, I think, what he's talking about. He
says, you'd have to be like a monkey.
Right.
Like just beat.
There's John masturbating, of course.
There he is again, jerking off. Jerk off, Johnny. Oh, shit.
Watch that hair.
Fucking A. Calm down, jerk off, Johnny.
But again, it would have to be pretty much nonstop. And he then gets into, well, if you're really worried about it, but you shouldn't be, you can take a vitamin A supplement. But that would, again, be ridiculous.
You can incorporate that just for good measure.
Are you taking any supplements these days or no?
It's funny you ask that. I took I tried this vitamin smoothie mix yesterday, and I had to cancel plans because I had like violent diarrhea all the rest of the night. Ah. It fucking sucked, bro. The homies was hanging out with chicks and stuff. They're like, come on through, and I just had to, I was like, I can't, bro. I wasn't like shitting on myself, but I had to keep running to the bathroom, you know? Like, you don't want to do that when you're out at the bar or some shit.
Well, I mean, I don't know if this was an episode or a phase you're going through, but for a while there, it seemed like every week you had a new supplement, whether it was for the brain, maybe the semen. You were always...
I was doing that was like nootropics and shit. I was just trying to find caffeine, shit instead of caffeine.
Ah, okay. You don't have a medicine cabinet stocked full of pills.
I,
Well, maybe you
nah. I can't even like the caffeine pill was that one, and actually worked. The caffeine pill that was cool, but like all I had to do was remember to just take it right before the show.
Oh, okay.
So like it wasn't that big of a deal.
Shit, those people up again. Kind of like those little caffeine little cubes they sent us.
Straight up, yo, old people, man. They go the fuck in. I remember my grandma. She had like a. She had like 20 different fucking things she'd take.
Oh, sure.
I'm like, man, it's got to be tough on your stomach. She just went in. She would take that shit.
Well, I do have some good news.
Oh, really?
And now, time for good news.
Now, since you hate the planet, I'm not sure you will like this, but it does seem to be a good thing. So hundreds of U.S. cities are composting their food waste, and this helps farmers and then cuts down on emissions because supposedly, I guess the landfill is full of food waste. It makes up nearly 20%. And when that food decomposes, it releases methane, 10 times more potent than carbon dioxide and things like that. But the point being really...
So how are they just going in after the fact, after you throw the shit out and separating shit, or do you got to separate it on your own? How's that work?
Well, the cities, certainly here in California, this is starting to happen where you're going to have a food waste bin, and then that's going to go to a place where they can compost it and then ship it back out to farmers and stuff like that. And again, they're, you know, it's, you know, for Detroit, I mean, it's not impossible. It seems a little unlikely, but they may have a similar program or looking at it because again, this
yeah,
is,
right.
Yeah, I know. I mean, and by the way,
stop it, John.
You know, when I say it's happening in LA, there's no way it's happening in my neighborhood. Absolutely not. Not a chance. But if you're in Beverly Hills, probably. But you've got a backyard. You could get the compost thing going. I think we had one as a kid. We had a compost pile.
Yeah, I'm not against composting. I don't give a fuck. Yeah, that's fine with that. I'm okay with. You act like I just fucking hate the world. I just like people more. Like, I like people, and I'm not gonna worry about the world will be okay. No matter what, the world's gonna be fine. We might not be, but like the world's straight, but I'm not gonna stress out over the fucking shit. And if you wanna fucking, you know, recycle things or, you know, do whatever makes you feel good, go ahead, do that shit. Whatever floats your boat. I just don't give a fuck. No.
I'll bet your mom has plenty of ideas about compost piles.
Oh my God. All the women, man, like all the women in my fucking life, fucking recycling and shit. I'm like, hey, you ain't doing nothing. Like, I ain't doing a fucking thing, but making you feel good. So if that's, you know, some people like to feel good. So there you go.
You can throw your watermelon back in the compost pile, whatever else you got going on.
Yeah, man, I'm from a hippie family, bro. We've been composting since composting, bro. Well, I got one in the backyard right now.
You do?
I just don't use it. I don't give a fuck. I'm not growing nothing, so you know, like it makes sense if you got a garden. If you're not, like, I don't know what the fuck you're gonna do.
Yeah.
But what do I know? That's cool. That's great, man. That's really neat.
Composting.
I guarantee you, the composting people have a dog that sleeps with them.
Probably.
Yeah, they do. Nah. I don't like people. I just like animals. Shut the fuck up, bitch. All right, that's the news.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Shay 45, that was the show. Thanks to Scott Burnstein. You can listen to his podcast, Original Gangster. He's fucking good. You throw him a question, he had an answer for every single thing. And there was like 7 different types of questions.
When you write a lot about something, it seems to really help you learn plenty of things. You can go deep on topics.
Oh, bro, yeah.
It's just the way it is.
Yeah, he'll take you through there on that shit. Yeah, he was good. Yeah, he talks about all the gangster shit. It's fun to listen to. Thanks to Keenan at Kylo Keen and John Z. Matthews at John Z. Matthews. What's the Z stand for? Nothing. Just like John. What does John stand for? Nothing.
Empty vessel.
Nope. Yep. If you stand for nothing, you'll fall for anything, John. Remember that.
Good.
Might have to put that on a t-shirt. Tune in tomorrow for more All Out Show. Until then, we're the fuck out. Have a good one. Bye.